All right, y'all. Well, we're going to go ahead and get started. Colin is going to take over the first session for us. If you guys look on your screen right here, there's going to be a quick PowerPoint, just a visual for you guys. But at the same time, you know, part of you guys being a part of the session and getting paid is also participating, right? So, you know, when Colin's doing his segment, he might have some questions for you guys, or if you guys have any ideas, or if you guys want to say something, just feel free to raise your hand and we'll call on you and we'll get you into the mix. You know what? It's because it's not really all about us telling you guys how to live your life and what to do. I'm sure there's some great things that you guys are doing right now, especially during COVID, being stuck at home, that you're doing, that you could teach us, that that will also help us to implement that in our homes and what we're doing. So don't be, you're also a teacher in this room too, okay? So, but Colin, I'm gonna hand it over to you, my man.
All right, no, great introduction. That was a blast. Larry, I'm interested to know what your favorite movie is of all time.
Okay, my favorite movie is Cinderella Man with Russell Crowe.
Nice.
It's not about Cinderella, y'all. It's about boxing, okay?
Oh, sure. Okay. Right on. So we're going to jump into this. Let's see. So today we're going to be talking about mental health, and then Larry's going to cover job tips a little bit later. But yeah, you know, Larry already touched on this a little bit, and he said, you know, with COVID the past year, it's already been a whole year. A lot of us have been stuck at home. I'm curious to know if anybody's willing to share, what are some things that you've done to kind of cope? Like, what are some things you've done to kind of stay sane, like not go crazy? If anybody's willing to share, I would love to hear it. Type it in the chat or shout it out.
I got a puppy.
Yes. Sorry. Puppy's cold, man. Anybody else? May?
I read books.
Beautiful.
I've read about 376 books already since quarantine started.
Wait, how many books?
376.
Right, how?
It's 24/7. I don't stop reading. So
that's amazing. Wow. Okay. I'm seeing a bunch of stuff in the chat too. People baking and cooking a lot. Ivan said listening to music. Sandra said I work out. Gianna, fellow reader. Love it. Anybody else want to share? Chris Neve said I work out and stretch. Yes. Anybody else? Running. 100%.
Netflix series.
Mm-hmm. Netflix series. Listening to music, going hiking. Anime. Nice. No, this is, riding my ATV. Let me borrow it. Got a boyfriend. Listening to music and cooking a lot, gaming a lot. Man, you guys got all kinds of stuff. Okay, I love this. Amazing. So yeah, we're gonna talk a little bit about some other tips that we might have for you as far as how to remain sane. We're going into the summer, and so hopefully these tips we provide will be a little bit helpful. Maybe you're already doing it, maybe not, but I'm just gonna jump straight into this. We only have an hour together, so. What we're talking about today, and I know a bunch of stuff is in the chat right now, I'll come back to it later, but what we're talking about today is recreating your space. And so, granted, it's been a year already, and so you may or may not have already done this, but this is something that, you know, Larry and I have found to be extremely, extremely helpful, especially now that we're working from home. You guys are doing school from home. Recreating your space just looks like kind of reimagining that whatever space it is that you occupy the most, right? So whether that be your bedroom or your bed, or you maybe have a desk or an office space or a kitchen table, you know, recreating your space is huge. So if I could have somebody come off mute, just read this first line here in bold.
The big one?
Yep.
Recreate your space. This frees up mental space to create.
Perfect. So that's huge. Sometimes we forget how easy it is to like just clutter our space, right? And it becomes so cluttered that we can lose focus because we're humans. And we get distracted very, very easily. And so if we have, you know, just a bunch of stuff on our desk or our room is constantly messy, like it's so hard to really focus and be creative, at least for a lot of us. I know some of us are that special person that can only be creative in a mess, but for the most of us, I would say it's a whole lot easier to be creative in a clear space. Can somebody hop off mute and read that second line, please?
Cleaning up your room seems annoying and oversimple, but really it can bring you tons of mental relief.
Can anybody agree with this? Does anybody agree? Like when your space is clear, you feel better? Some of you, maybe not. Hold on, I gotta see what's going on in the chat here. Yep, 100%. Okay, somebody said they just cleaned their room today. And it is, and this is something like there are books about this. Literally, there are books that the number one thing that you can do to make your day better is make your bed. And we just take that for granted sometimes, right? We just don't make it. We just get up, we just get started with our day. And we forget that one simple task of just making your bed, making your space look nice again, right? And so I'm gonna read this last line. It says, not only does cleaning your space give you more room to be creative, it's a great starting place to feel more productive in the other things you need to do or the other things you need to get done that day. So what I mean by that is this, I'm wondering, and I'm not, you don't have to, you know, point yourself out, but I'm guessing that a lot of us may have struggled with some mental kind of health this year. And I, you know, whether it's in the form of anxiety, depression, fear, loneliness, like that's a lot of us. And I know that I've dealt with it. And I've been a stay-at-home dad. So I've got kids and I've had to be a stay-at-home dad before. And just being home by yourself, even with a kid, is it'll mess with you mentally. And so one of the things that I found was so helpful to me was this. It was to find a space that I could clear and clean. And that allowed me to be more productive for the rest of my day and to get the rest of my stuff done. So if I started to feel, you know, maybe if you've ever felt anxiety, you start to get loops, right? You start thinking the same thought over and over and over again, right? You take that energy and kind of put it into some sort of small task, maybe cleaning your room, maybe washing the dishes. That will allow your mentality to start thinking productively again. Like, okay, I can do this. I can move forward. It's just something that's been really, really helpful. And like I said, it's very simple and easy, right? But a lot of times we forget to do it. Let me see what's going on in the chat here again. Yeah, I love you guys' feedback. This is awesome. Making your bed helps so much. Somebody else said something.
I'm guessing too, like a lot of people have become like master chefs over this time too, right? Y'all have stepped up your foodie game, right, at your house. I mean, you're making it's not just a grilled cheese sandwich anymore. It's like the extra, right? You putting that bacon in there, you grilling those onions, you put it all up in there, making it, amazing. But just think about it. Like anytime you think about like some of your chef creations that y'all making, if it was real disorganized, right? And you did, all your ingredients were all over the place, it would take so long just to figure out what the heck you were doing. But typically when you're trying to make something, you plan it out, right? You got your pepper, you got your salt, you got your meat set aside. So everything's organized. So when you go to actually cook it, it's something that's consistent. And it's going to come out great. So I just wanted to point that out.
Yeah, no, it's so true. And, you know, you guys are mentioning things and I want to go back to those a little bit because, you know, people were mentioning other things. And if I was you, I would kind of take advantage of this list that people just put on here, because this is amazing. This is a great list. And if there are things that you're not doing on this list that people have put in the chat, I would try it out and see which one works for you. Because, you know, we've got a little ways. I know we're getting our vaccinations and people are starting to get back to normal. We've got a little ways to go. And so our goal as far as with these workshops is really just to make sure that we're heading into the summer with really with excitement and just with a clear mental space. Larry, is there anything else you wanted to add on to that?
No, as long as we're gonna go into that activity, I think we're good.
Yeah, let's jump right into this activity. So we are gonna we're gonna do this, and I want you guys to grab a piece of paper and a pen or a pencil. And we're going to quickly recreate our space. So think of whatever space you're in the most. I see some of you in the kitchen, some in the family room, some in the bedroom. We're gonna quickly draw on a piece of paper the space that you're in.
You're recreating your space, right? How you would want it to be. You could take the pieces that are in your room and arrange that. Or you could say, yo, if I had a projector, this is where I would put it. This is where it would go on the wall, right? Stuff like that.
All right.
Yeah. I want you guys to use your imagination to be creative. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean. I'm just imposing that you give it to me and just me only. Yeah. Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean. I'm just imposing that you give it to me and just me only. Cause you chosen. Sound is in the air. No, you can't bring no phones in. We walk in and they're like, what's all the commotion? No, he can't step a foot in here if we don't know him. Treat you special, girl, I hit you with the roses. Can't say your boyfriend ain't too controlling. Get along better with me. Get up when you bust wide open. Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only. Yeah, girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only. You only got me when you're drunk, yeah. Only text you when I'm on. I said that we're in love. You probably tell me that I'm wrong. But I know I always get you in the eye. But I know I always get you in the eye. But I know I always get you in the eye. I'm in the building and I'm feeling myself. You was doing bad, I was willing to help. I said, stop it, baby, I'm popping, baby. Lifestyle drive you crazy. Know you really wanna go, whoa, whoa. Know you really wanna take it slow, whoa, whoa. Tell them pass the Henny, we don't do so go. Me and you together, we can do no wrong. Girl, it's your soul. Hey, I swear it's only you. Put up cause you told me to. Cause I do it how you want me to. We're gonna give you guys about 3 more minutes. And this is something that you can continue on after this session is done, right? If you wanna continue to create this piece, we want you to do that. It might be something that you might be able to implement. Some of these items, you might be able to actually do this. I know for me, like one of my, when I was going to high school, one of the biggest things I did was I made a collage wall. I literally cut out stuff from magazines and I pasted it on my wall. So my whole wall was full of like hip hop stuff. It was full of hip hop imagery, whether it was graffiti, whether it was art, turntables, people MCing, because it was a dream of mine. It was a dream of mine to do that. So I wanted to have it in front of me. That's what I did. And sure enough, that was something I was able to do later on. That's just the idea. That's going amazing. But if you reach for it, you ain't coming back with nada. Keep you in Nevada in the summer. Susie number one stunner. Got gas like an H1 Hummer. Turn a good girl to a track runner. Don't wanna problem. And my checks keep a whole lot of come on, just going up. DJ Etch, you can find a cool instrumental to put on while some of the students get ready to share their piece. I want to be able to hear them we can put on some instrumentals if they could speak over. I am no longer trying to survive. Appreciate you. I believe that life is a prize. But to live doesn't mean you're alive. Don't worry about me and who I fire. I get what I desire. My curiosity, is there anybody ready to share right now? Anybody say, you know what, I think I got a basic layout of how I want things. You might want to share it just for the sake of being creative.
I'll share.
Thank you, Mary. I appreciate that.
I did not make a layout of my room, but I created a layout of a house.
Oh, good job. And so, tell us about it. Okay, so I see a lot of stuff on there. Tell us what you got. Tell us what you got going on in there.
So I want a big open house with big windows. And I want to be where there's wilderness. There isn't like buildings or like, you know, I want to be where it's isolated. And then I want my sisters to have their own room. My mom to have her garden because she loves flowers. She loves planting. And then I made a big outdoor. So like, cause I have a lot of dogs and I would want them to have a big space. So that's pretty much it.
Hey, thank you so much for sharing that. That's super creative. That's super dope. You know what? Let me ask you this. Do you think you could actually achieve that one day?
Yes, I will achieve it. I will buy a house for my family. That's what I'm going to do.
High five. I love that. I love that. Good job. All right. Should I get maybe one or two other people to share?
Ooh, I'll go.
All right. Let's go.
So, I don't know if you can see it. It's kind of messy. But I just like did a layout of my room because I redecorated everything during the summer last year.
Okay.
But so I have a projector like over my bed. I don't know if you can see it there.
Oh, I see it. Yeah.
Yeah. So there's that. The only thing I need to add is a rug. Because I don't know.
Oh, that's totally cool. Love it. Do you often redecorate your room like every year?
This is my third time doing it this year.
Got it. So you actually, yes. But that's what we're saying, like, right? Make your space speak to you. If you have the opportunity, you can, because that's really going to help you, right? If you make it your way, if you put items in there that really inspire you and encourage you, it's gonna really actually help, right? Because you're going to be in that space the most. So if it's all dark and dingy, sometimes that reflects on our attitude. But if it's a little bit more bright and open, and it's not like I don't like dark and dingy, but like, yo, maybe when I'm watching a movie, right? But like in the daytime, I kind of want to see the sun. I want to see the light. I want to feel the air, right? So anyways, great job with that. Let's get one more person to share, and then we're going to move on to our next day. We got anybody else?
I'll share.
Thank you, Kelly.
No problem. So I basically just did a layout of my room, but I added a few more things. I added a coffee table and a basketball hoop to it, and more light.
That's dope. That's really cool. Good job with that. So y'all, look, the reason why we did this activity, there was another method to our madness of why we had you guys do this, right? So just as easy as it was to sit there and maybe to put something together and to lay something out, we want you guys to start doing the same about your career and what you want to be, right? Like I want you to start thinking about like, what career do you want to go into? You know, maybe what job do you want to start to get into that will help you lead you into that career? Or maybe even start thinking about college or school or some type of training. It's literally that easy. What you just did right now, what you put on paper, and we just did that in 5 minutes. You came up with a whole layout in your room. You know what? You could actually do that with your career and get yourself started on that path. And you can have fun with it just like that. You could be extremely creative. You could draw all kinds of pictures. You could make a roadmap. As long as it's something that you can visually see, and it's something that you want to do, it belongs to you. It's yours. It's not mine. It's not something your mom and dad told you to do. It really belongs to you, right? And so I want to encourage you into that, because as we go along in our sessions, we're going to start building our way and to start thinking about some of those type of things, all right?
Okay.
All All right, so we could put that activity away. We're gonna go on to some job and career stuff, okay? And we're just gonna have a conversation. I want to really answer these five questions, and I want you guys to be able to, answer along and talk along with me about this, because maybe these are also some of the questions you guys have, or maybe information you might need to know. All right. So I'm just going to say the six questions, and then we're going to go over each one of them. All right. So here's the questions we're going to go over today. You know, what is the difference between a job and a career? All right. We're going to give examples of what those are. Why is there a minimum wage? How do I earn more money on my job? Should I even get a job right now? Right. Since I'm in school. And then when should I start thinking about a career? So those are the questions we're going to answer today, but let's start with the very first one. So what is actually the difference between a job and a career? Can anybody tell me?
Or what would you... I have a question. I think a career is like forever, right?
Yes. It could be forever. You would want it to be forever, right? But how would you get to forever? Well, like, what type of attitude would you have to do something forever?
That you love doing?
Who said that? Who said love? Ivan and then Maiden, you said that. Y'all said that, like, exactly the same time. Like, that's exactly right. Your career, if you're going to have one and it's going to be real long, it has to be something that you love, right? Because if you just kind of like it, you're just going to kind of do it. Right? It will only last a certain amount of time, kind of like a relationship. You know what I mean? Like, if you just kind of like that person, you're just going to kind of maybe go on a couple of dates and it's going to fizzle out and become nothing. But if you actually fall in love with that person, there's a lot more longevity to it, right? So think about that as your career. Like, what is something that you like to do? And then write those things down, and then you might figure out which one do you feel is the best for you and that you want to go into. And that's the beauty about searching for careers. You can decide what you want to do. Colin doesn't have to decide for you. I don't have to decide for you. Your parents don't. It really has to be something that connects with you. So I just want to get that started in your head and in your heart, because it's, you guys are going to face that once you guys graduate high school, right? And that's going to be like some of you guys is right now. It's like your next step. You're about to graduate high school and you're trying to think of, man, what's next for me, right? All right. So who could give me another, what do you call it? Example of a job and a career. Cause you guys nailed the career. Something you love and it'll last a long time. Give me an example of what a job is compared to a career.
Babysitting.
Job is like temporary.
Yes. Yeah.
I think like the difference of a job and career is something like you're passionate about. Cause I was looking through Opera and I see a lot of jobs like Food Max is hiring for a job, but like I don't think anyone's career wants to be bagging groceries or anything.
No.
So you can tell like the difference in like energies. Yeah.
No, absolutely. But that doesn't negate, like, that doesn't make Food Max not a good job, right? Yeah. It's a good starter job. And actually at Food Max, you could learn how to do warehousing, right? You could learn how to itemize. Like, let's say in the future, you wanted to open your own store. Let's say it was a clothing store or a shoe store or a hat store. You'll learn about merchandising. You'll learn all about the layout and how to do that, right? So those starter jobs, a lot of times, are the very beautiful beginnings of you becoming who you're going to be later on, right? So don't ever take your first jobs for granted, whether it's Taco Bell, McDonald's, or whatever, because, yo, that's the foundation. I see Chris is like, nah, man, I ain't working at McDonald's. But, yo, you know what? Those double cheeseburgers, no pickles, are smacking, right? Anyways, all right, so... So you guys get it though. You guys get the difference between a job and a career. You guys did an amazing job on that. Let's go to this. Let me ask this question. Why is there a minimum wage? Why do you guys think there's a minimum wage? Do we know what we all know what a minimum wage is though, right? So a minimum wage is like the, the least amount you can make on a job. So let's say you're going to work for, I don't know, the gas station. I'm just making stuff up. I probably could have thought of something way more creative than that. But let's just say the gas station, and their minimum wage is $13.25. Like, that's the least, that's like the starter position, right? And there may be a way to get more money on that. But for you who have, so nobody who has any experience, they would start at that. Why do you think there is a minimum wage? To stabilize the economy, that's deep, yes, but that's very true, right? Everything cannot always just be at $25, $30 an hour, because there comes a lot of skills with that, right? And that's something we want to work up to, right? Man, making $25, $30 an hour, you start doing the math, that looks good on the paycheck, you know, but that also comes with you becoming really good at what you do, right? Typically, how many, can I just get a raise of your hands? How many of y'all actually have a job? Nobody has a job yet? Okay, that's crazy. That's cool. But that's why we got Colin here. We're going to help you if y'all want to get to that next step. But here's the thing. The thing that you learn about when you get your first job is you realize really all the stuff that you don't know. And then you also find out all the good things that you do know, right? And so it's a little bit of both. So that's why it's always good to jump in a job. It doesn't matter what it is, because you most times you have a minimum wage job and it's like a kind of a low paying job is because it depends on what you're doing, right? The skill level it takes to jump into that job. As your skills grow, as you become stronger in what you do, that's we call that your value. Your value actually goes up, right? So let's say you take a training, you get a food safety certificate. Man, your value just went up a little bit because now you know a little bit more than that next person does. And you got a certificate of training, right? Or you took 8 workshops with Colin. He broke things down to you. Now you got a certificate through Hybrid of Work that says you went through all this job training. Yo, you add that to your resume, your value just went up. You know what I mean? And then as it's almost the same thing with your degree. Once you get your degree with school, yo, your value just went way up. What you could actually make if you didn't graduate high school, I think it's something like you could only make around $12,000 to $15,000 a year based on not having a degree. But once you get your degree, that thing jumps up to almost $30,000. That's just for you getting that certificate. So that's why you want to work hard and do what you guys are doing, okay? So hang in there and keep doing what you're doing and moving forward and use us as a catalyst to help you to get to where you guys need to go. Here's another question. How do you earn more money on a job if you're making minimum wage? How would you make more money? How would you guys think you would make more money on a job? I'm gonna give you guys a secret. I'm gonna give you some secret sauce, okay? It's an acronym called CCI. You might wanna write this down. The letter CCI, all right? I'm gonna give you a gold nugget right now. CCI is basically, the first C is if you have good communication skills. If you're able to communicate well, that means with your boss, your supervisors, the people you work with on your job, you're gonna be really successful on your job, right? And you guys know also when you communicate, in order to be a good communicator, it's not just about being a good talker, right? It's also about being what?
Listening.
Yes, thank you, Jessica. Right on, high fives. Like, you have to be a good listener, and that because you have to hear what the other person said to you and to process their information, and that becomes the full gamut of what communication is, right? So that's the first one. That's the first C. The second C is consistency, right? Being consistent. That means if you're going to show up early on your job, every single day to work, that you show up every single day at your job early. That's being consistent. But what does that show to your supervisor or to the boss that you that hired you if you're able to get there early every single day?
You're responsible.
Dang, responsible. Guess what? You might even pick up the shift that the other person who didn't decide to show up to go to work, you get this clock in a little bit early and you get those extra hours. That's more money in your pocket. That's just by being responsible, right? So anyways, so that's it. So you got You got your communication, you got consistency, and the last one, the I, is initiative. Who knows what does initiative mean? Who can tell me what that means?
You approach things?
You approach things in what manner? I'll give you a hint. It's something that you do. Somebody doesn't have to tell you to go do this. That's initiative, right? Like, be honest, y'all, how many of y'all got chores? Y'all got chores? Yeah, like, I got too many damn chores, right? You're like, man, I wish they'd give me a break. Anyways, if your mom don't have to tell you to do the chores, or your dad, or your guardian, whoever it is, and you just go do it, you know what, man, I guarantee you, you're going to put a smile on someone's face. Shoot, you might even get a raise in your allowance if that's even still happening, right? But like, yo, like if that, and that's, and that, let's say like, nah, I ain't have it over here. So it's about just doing it without being told, and that's you being responsible. You know what I'm saying? Like, you already know you have to do it. Why should somebody tell you have to go do it? If you could be a good communicator, if you could be consistent, and if you could show initiative on your job, y'all gonna be successful. That's the secret sauce, y'all. That's it, those three things. Now, obviously there's a little bit more to the story of all of that, but if you could just master those three things, whatever job you go to, you will be in good hands. And I know Collin can attest to this. Collin being a business owner, you know what I mean? He runs a coffee company. My man Jeremy works over here at the Chase Center. He's not only a great DJs on the ones and twos, but he's also a great sound engineer. He does music production. He works at the Chase Center. Like y'all in good hands right now. Like, I don't think you understand these three people that are in front of y'all, like what we do and how long we've been doing it. And we work with Mary and some of the other folks at Conley to make sure that we got this group, because we wanted to make sure that you guys got supported, right, in what you were doing, because y'all are grinding, y'all are hustling, and it's not easy, right? And not everybody's situation is the same, but like, we got your back. That's why we're here. This is why we're doing this. And we wanted to make sure we put some money into your hands so we can help you guys out a little bit. All right. So guys, we were at 251. All right. So here's what we're gonna do. Everybody here got a cell phone, right? We're gonna play a quick game of Kahoot to go over all of the information we've done, okay? Remember, the top three winners will win a prize. That means you could choose a gift. I think the gift card is $25 for first prize, $15 for second prize, and $10 for third prize, okay? So whoever wins those, we're gonna write those down and we'll mail it out to you next week, all right? All right, so give me a quick second. As the DJ spins a little bit, give me a quick second to set up the game and I'll send you the code, okay? Here we go. It's showtime at the Apollo minus the Kiki Shepherd. With about a bottle, with a leopard print. Teddy, Pendergrass, cooler than Freddie Jackson, sipping a milkshake in a snowstorm. That felt warm in the dorm room at the AU. We blew hate to athletes, might cake you, but you must have been mistaken with them statements that you make, huh? All right, so the code's up on the screen. Let's make sure we get all of you guys in. True or false, y'all? Recreating your personal space adds no value to your life. Y'all, all y'all got that wrong? All right. Here we go. cleaning up your room and organizing your workspace will help you. There you go. Yo, if that yo made me get better grades, I'd do it every single day forever. All right, y'all. Here we go. Let's see who's in the lead right now. All right, Anna's in the lead. Here we go, but it's pretty close. True or false, y'all? Adding things to your room that you like and inspire you will affect you in a positive way. Yes, yes. Good job, y'all. Uh-oh, M-Dog is coming. Here we go. True or false, y'all? Sharing a room with someone makes it impossible to organize and be creative. False. Actually, if you guys, it doesn't make it impossible because it's your room, right? Maybe one side might be split to the other, but you're still responsible for your side. So make it speak to you. It's all good. All right, Anna M-Dog still up. 1 and 2. Jose's in third. Here we go. Writing things down or drawing out ideas is an outdated way of planning. Right, so no, it's actually not out. You all just did it right now. Y'all just did it, and it's supposed to help you, right? Visualize what you're doing, okay? It's not outdated, even though we have computers and things like that. It's not outdated. Some of these are trick questions, so just be very careful about the way it's worded, all right? Anna's still in first place. Ivan's coming up, and Gigi's there. Here we go. The difference between a job and a career is good job, y'all. It is all the above. All right, here we go. We still got Anna, Ivan, Gigi in first and third place. Here we go. True or false? Minimum wage is the most you can make at a job. No, minimum wage is the least you can make at a job. All right. Here we go. Jose's still back in the race. He's still top five. All right, here we go, y'all. You could earn more money on a job by go. Good job. Remember, the CCI, that was the secret sauce, y'all. That was secret sauce. Y'all got it. Most of y'all got that. All right. Man, Anna and Ivan, they are still up there. And we got Gigi, Jose, and Jess. We're down to the last questions. Here we go. True or false? Getting a job will teach me responsibility and help me earn my own money. Absolutely. 100% of y'all got that right. Thank you. Makes me feel good when everybody gets it all right. All right, y'all. We're going to this is the final. We're down in the final question. Top five so far, Anna, Ivan, Gigi, Jose, Jess. Let's go. The best time to start thinking about your career is right now. Right, absolutely stinking right now, y'all. All right, here we go. Let's see who won. All right, coming in third place, we got Ivan. Ivan, you won a $10 gift card. Gigi, you won a $15 gift card. And number one is Anna. Anna, you are the winner. Yes. All right. Good job, y'all. All right. Well, y'all, look, it is 3:02. We kept you 2 minutes over, y'all. And you guys have already had a long day. Look, thank you for hanging out with us. I hope you guys enjoyed your time. We want you guys to come back the following, not next week, but the next week, right? Are y'all with us for the whole time? All right, please. And then tell a friend about this and say, y'all, you got to be a part of this dope workshop. You got to hang out with our friends, Larry and Collin and DJ Etch, all right? Look, guys, if you have to go, I totally understand. If you guys want to hang out, DJ Etch is going to spin for the next 5 to 10 minutes, and we're just going to hang out over here. Thank you guys so much. We recorded you guys down. Collin will be in touch with you guys throughout the week. Love you guys. Thank you guys for hanging out.
Thanks, everybody. Good to see everyone.
Good job. Take care. Oh, good job, y'all.
Wanted to change it up a little bit.
There you go.
There you go.
Yeah. How far is heaven? Lord, can you tell me?